Good evening, everyone, and Merry Christmas. I am so glad to be able to say that word. That is so awesome. Hey, we're here. We made it. And we welcome you to this very special online edition of our Christmas Eve service. You know, for all the years that we've been here, we've never done anything like this. But then again, we've never had a year quite like 2020 either. So, you know what? It's in our darkest hour, though, that God's light shines the brightest. And we are so excited about the way the Holy Spirit has guided us in all our planning for this holy night. Greg, as usual, you've been hard at work behind the scenes getting ready for all our Christmas Eve services. So tell us what's happening.
Well, it's really exciting. And we don't know how and when you're watching this right now, but we had two services, or we're having two services today. But one's at 2 o'clock, and it's outside under the patio where we've been meeting every Sunday. And we're going to have organ music outside. It's crazy. And if you've been in the church parking lot in the last few weeks, you'll see that we're building the stage up on top of a building. And the 5 o'clock service, you drive in, like drive-in style. You can sit in your car, turn on the FM station, and hear everything we do. Or you can get out of your car. We have a special seating area, and you'll find market lights and hay bales there. But I want to let you know, if you're watching it here, you're getting all the same components that we're doing out there live. It's just we're not together in person, but we are together as the body of Christ at Sunrise Fallbrook. And I do want to tell you, speaking of staying connected, we got a great website, sunrisefallbrook.com, where you can actually go and give your offering. You can get weekly updates. Actually, you can get daily updates. It's a website, so you can get like minute-by-minute updates, I suppose. But we just want to say thank you. Thank you for being part of this body of Christ. We're blessed to have this great shepherd in our Lord. We're blessed to have the staff we have here. Everybody's worked hard behind the scenes, and we just want to glorify the Lord with everything we do and say. So let's worship him tonight, right now.
Amen. Folks, without a doubt, this has been the strangest and the toughest year we've ever had to endure. Darkness and death have covered our land like never before. I'm talking about physically and politically and spiritually. From this day forward, think of this, 2020 will forever be known as the year of the pandemic. But listen, truly, throughout history, Christians have faced times of hardship and suffering, not with doubt and fear and anxiety, but with hope and faith and singing. And it's all because of Emmanuel, God with us. 2,000 years ago, on that first Christmas Eve, an angel of the Lord appeared to some terrified shepherds, and he said, "Fear not. I bring you good news of great joy for all the people. Today in the city of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord." And at that moment, all heaven and nature sang. It happens every Christmas all around the world, doesn't it? It's amazing. Suddenly the darkness is replaced by light, and people everywhere begin to sing for joy. So friends, tonight, we invite you to leave your fears behind as we gather around the manger and sing some of our most beloved carols for the Christ child. And may the Prince of Peace restore our souls and grant us rest and joy as we celebrate the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Yes. Let's pray together as we begin our service. Holy Lord, if ever we needed some tidings of comfort and joy, it's tonight. Mm-hmm. If ever we needed to be reconciled and reunited as a nation and a people, it's tonight. If ever we needed to be reminded that your light shines in the darkness and the darkness has not overcome it, it is tonight. So come, Holy Spirit, and descend upon us, we pray. Come overshadow us, just as you did Mary, so that Christ might be born in us as well. Tonight, as we read your inspired word and as we hear the beautiful story of the Nativity once again, replace our groaning with laughter, Lord. Replace our tears with songs of joy. Tonight we lift up our hearts and we sing with the angels, "Glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled." And everyone said, Amen.
Tonight we begin our service with the lighting of these sacred candles. Long ago the prophet Isaiah declared, "There will be no more gloom for those who are in distress. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. and he will be called Wonderful Counselor.
Mighty God,
Everlasting Father,
Prince of Peace.
Tonight we invite you to gather around the manger of the Christ child and sing for joy. Jesus, our Savior, is born.
Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ our Lord.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Oh, sing, choirs of angels, sing in exultation. Sing, all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. And yes, Lord, we greet thee, born this happy morning. Jesus, to thee be all glory given. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
But you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. Therefore, Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labor gives birth, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth, and he will be their peace.
Luke 2:1-7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Oh, come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lonely exile here. Until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou rod of Jesse, thine own from Satan's tyranny. From depths of hell thy people save, and give them victory o'er the grave. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou day spring, come and cheer our spirits by thine advent here. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night, and death's dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples, but the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Herds of camels will cover your land, young camels of Midian and Ephah, and all from Sheba will come, bearing gold and incense and proclaiming the praise of the Lord. I see him, but not here and now. I perceive him, but far in the distant future, a star will rise from Jacob.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
Light of the world, treasure of heaven, brilliant like the stars in the wintry sky. Joy of the Father, reach through the darkness, shine across the earth, send the shadows to fly. Light of the world, from the beginning, the tragedies of time were no match for your love. From great heights of glory, you saw my story. God, you answered him and became one of us.
When the army of angels returned again to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this wonderful thing that the Lord has told us about. So they ran to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there, the baby lying in the manger.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Inspire your heavenly song. Oh, in excelsis Deo. Come to Bethlehem and see him whose birth the angels sing. Come adore on bended knee Christ the Lord, the newborn King. Oh,
When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Glowing heart.
A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Friends, because of this holy night, the script of history is totally flipped and everything changes. The curse of sin is broken and the day of our salvation has come. The last are now first and the first last. God has brought down rulers from their thrones and lifted up the humble. And Jesus Christ, the bright and morning star, is born into the world to make all things new. So in just a minute, we're going to light the Christ candle, and then we're going to sing Silent Night together. But before we do that, let's prepare our hearts as Pastor Greg reads from God's inspired word from the Gospel of John.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Folks, when Jesus came into the world, it was dark and cold, and the earth was filled with sin and disease and death. Why would the Lord of all creation ever leave the glory and comfort of heaven to visit our wounded planet? You know, why should he? The Bible says we live in a fallen world, cursed by sin and by our own rebellion against God, and the wages of sin is death. Friends, without a doubt, 2020 has been a year filled with darkness, confusion, and sorrow. It has challenged us and exhausted us like no other year before it. Yet, in the dark streets shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. Do you believe that? That is the astounding, miraculous good news of Christmas. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." See, God so loved the world, he so loved you and me, that he became small. Small enough to sleep in a feeding trough for farm animals because there was nowhere else for him to lay his head. Small enough to be cradled and embraced in Mary's arms as she sang a lullaby to her newborn son. Small enough to see the world through our eyes and experience the same joy and pain and suffering that we do. And small enough to actually die on a cursed tree for our sins, not his, so that we might receive the gift of eternal life. He humbled himself and became what we are so that we might become what he is, a beloved child of our Heavenly Father. Tonight, as we sing Silent Night, folks, I invite you to open your heart and let the Prince of Peace come in. Receive him tonight as the Son of God, as love's pure light, and may the radiant beams from his holy face fill the world with joy and peace that only he can bring. Let's sing now as we worship our King Christ the Savior is born. Folks, let's declare this proclamation of Christ's birth responsibly as the people of God. God has caused this holy night to shine with the brightness of His true and everlasting light, and the darkness cannot overcome it. For unto us is born this day a Savior, who is Christ the Lord.
And now with the angels we sing, and with the shepherds we shout,
Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and joy to the world.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas, everyone. The peace of Christ be with you.